Warren Gatland urges Wales to front up to gargantuan France pack in Six Nations opener. Wales may need harpoons to slay French beasts in Paris on Friday night, as they face one of the heaviest packs ever assembled. France have picked monstrous forwards who weigh a combined 153 pounds, with Uini Atonio the tighthead prop, and converted South African lock Paul Willemse both over 20. But that holds no fear for Warren Gatland, who wants his side to run the big boys around at the Stade de France. "It's an exciting challenge," said the Wales head coach. "We're coming under a bit of pressure. They clearly want to be big and physical up front and play some rugby when they get out wide. They've got a big, bruising forward pack and a back line with flair, talent and footwork. There is no doubt they will have a big go at our scrum and try to maul us off the park. They were pretty effective in the autumn in that area. We've got to be on our mettle, and from a defensive point of view it's paramount our line speed and collisions are good. We've been working on that and talking about stopping their forward momentum, which they can create from their pack. It's not the biggest back line in the world, but they'll try to play off the front foot and use that pace and skill of the backs. Wesley Fofana and Romain Tamak, and Camille Lopez has got a good kicking game, and Morgan Parra's back. The way we've tended to play against France is keep the ball on the park and not be afraid to kick long and try and find a bit of grass. They will kick a lot of ball out to try and slow the game down and play a lot off Parra at 9. Gatland, who has Ross Moriarty and Josh Navidi fit to form a back row turnover trio with Justin Tipuric, was surprised his opposite number Jacques Brunel left powerhouse center Matthew Bastard out of his 23. And he wants his team to target the replacement, 19-year-old Romain Tamak, son of former French back Emile, who is making his debut. "It's tough in your first big game," added Gatland. "There is no doubt he has had some big games for Toulouse and he is learning and doing well. When you go out in that first international, things are happening quicker than they have ever happened before, so your decision-making has to improve as the pace of the game is at a new level. For younger players, it can take a few games to get things under your belt. That may happen, or he might just slot straight in and be a superstar, you don't know. I go back to Jonathan Davis' first game in the stadium against Australia and he was like a rabbit in the headlights. We often joke about it. It took him 4 or 5 games and now he's a world-class center. We need to look at putting Tamak under pressure by challenging him on decision-making and defense, and giving him no time on the ball and making it a tough day for him." Nippy Tomos Williams, 24, making his first Six Nations start at scrum half, is preferred to Gareth Davis and is hoping to be a David among French Goliaths. "The Six Nations is a bigger stage than what I've played in, and France are a strong team," he said. "There's going to be a bit of pressure, but I'm looking forward to it. We will look to pull them about the park a bit. They have named a big pack, but we're not taking anything away from them. We know they are going to be good." Wales team to play France: L. Williams, North; J. Davis, Parks; Adams, Anscombe; T. Williams, R. Evans; Owens, Francis; Beard, R. Jones; C. Navidi, Tipuric, Moriarty. Replacements: D. W. Jones, Lee, Hill, Wainwright; G. Davis, Bigger, Watkin. France: Medard, Penaud, Fofana, Tamak, Huguet, Lopez, Parra, Poirot, Girotto, Captain, Atonio, Valmahina, Willemse, Lord, Iturria, Pickmoles. Replacements: Mark Hand, Prisso, Bambo, Lambie, Aldred, Sarin, Fiku, Dmeru.